सुनने वाले अभी फिलहाल सिर्फ मनोरंजन पर ध्यान दें, हकीकत में ऐसा कम ही होता है।
Hello folks, this is Ayatin Ajha from inspiredrise.com and this is the Moto X4. So guys, let's first begin with the unboxing for this one. It comes with a turbocharger inside the box, has a USB Type-C cable, in-ear style earphones, you get the warranty card, papers, etc. and also the SIM tray removal pin. It comes with a 5.2-inch 16:9 display with 1080p resolution. It also has Corning Gorilla Glass protection and a hybrid SIM tray slot, which is something that I personally don't like a lot. At the bottom, you have the USB Type-C, the 3.5mm jack and the antenna bands. On the right hand side, you get the power button and the volume rocker, which are separate buttons and feel quite clicky. At the back, there's that slight camera bump and the back has got quite a nice finish, but it's a fingerprint magnet and the smudges are real on this one. On the back, there's the dual camera module, the Moto logo and the dual tone LED flash, along with the small microphone for noise cancellation. And I think that the design of this phone is quite good. It feels really solid to hold in the hand and has got quite a nice feel, though the display is a little bit dated because it is not bezel-less or edge-to-edge. And if I talk about the Android experience on this one, then it comes with Android 7.1.1 Noga, and I feel that they will upgrade it soon to Android Oreo as it's the latest and the best of Android. The user interface is same as seen on Moto G5 S Plus and a lot of other Moto smartphones, and the basic Moto actions etc are all there. And let's set up the fingerprint sensor. One of the best things about it was that it was fast and worked almost every time that we used it. And now let's talk about what's under the hood. It comes with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 630 octa-core chipset. CPU Z is showing the wrong information over here. And it comes with Adreno 508 GPU and 3GB or 4GB of RAM, 32GB or 64GB of internal storage. And if you talk about the microSD expandable options, you can expand it up to 256GB. And one of the good things about this phone is that it comes with almost every sensor that you need for an amazing Android experience. So nothing is missed out on this phone. It has almost everything that you need for a great smartphone experience. And even the chipset on this one is quite powerful. The benchmark scores like the Antutu benchmark and the Nina Mark II benchmark show that the chipset is a above average scoring chipset and has quite good performance, though not near the flagship level, but still it's quite good. And now let's talk about one of the highlights of this phone, the camera setup on this one. It comes with dual sensors on the back, one is a wide angle one and one is a normal one, and it comes with a lot of modes like the depth enabled, portrait mode, etc. And now let's talk about the sensors in detail. So it comes with dual autofocus pixel technology and 1.4 micrometer pixel size, a 12 megapixel camera at the back, and a 1.12 micrometer pixel size on the 8 megapixel camera. And needless to say, the image quality from the pictures taken on this phone was quite good. I think among the best in this price range. So the front camera has a f2.2 aperture, the back camera has a f2.0 aperture, and the overall picture quality was seriously good. I was impressed. And this here is a video sample taken from the back camera of this device. And if you talk about the back camera in more detail, you also get a dual LED flash, auto HDR options, and few other options like face detection and touch focus also. One of the best things about it is that it can shoot in 4K at 30fps, and the secondary camera is a 16 megapixel one. The time taken to autofocus on this one was quite impressive, and now let me show you the same video taken from the wide angle lens for this smartphone. So the wide angle lens works almost perfectly, and you can see there's a lot more which is visible over here. And the front camera, if you talk about it, it shoots up to 1080p videos, and 1 micrometer is the pixel size, 16 megapixel is the sensor, and the best part about that is that it also comes with a dedicated LED flash on the front. And I have to say that Motorola has quite improved their camera game, and the camera on this device is quite good. The build quality etc for this phone screams that it's a premium device. And now let's test the audio playback for this one. There's only one front-facing speaker near the earpiece, and the audio was sufficient but not really loud, as is seen in a lot of smartphones these days. And if I talk about the other things like active display and few other Moto-specific features, they are all there. Now let's talk about the price. It would retail for a price of 20,999 for the 32GB variant and a slightly higher price, 23,000 for the 64GB variant. The launch offers include exchange offers, 10% discount on HDFC bank credit cards, 50% buyback value, 340GB data on Airtel, and few other options like EMIs, etc., all of which make it quite a lucrative option. And the device would be available in super black and sterling blue colors. And I feel that this device has filled a huge void which was present in the sub 25k price bracket for smartphones. And this device only has a 3000mAh battery, though I feel that it might last you almost throughout the day because Moto always does good optimization. But I think the battery could definitely have been more in capacity. And other than that, I feel there are very less issues with the smartphone. So guys, this was it for this video. In case you like this one, don't forget to smash that thumbs up button and do subscribe to Inspire to Rise for more awesome tech videos like this. And guys, no matter what you do, stay inspired to rise.